Hello everyone, it's Janelle here, Janelle Stewart that is, from Parents Making an Investment. Happy, happy new year to one and all. I am wishing everyone a happy and prosperous new year this year, 2020. And today I want to talk about atmosphere. Have you ever been somewhere, whether it's a party, whether it's someone's home, pretty much someone's home, and or even your house, and you can like sense the atmosphere, you can sense the energy in the atmosphere. And sometimes you like that energy. Sometimes it makes you feel comfortable. It makes you feel at home in someone else's home because of the atmosphere, and it just makes you feel warm and open. And if you go to a party, you sense the energy, and then there's times where you sense like not a good energy, and so that energy is kind of negative, or it's kind of the atmosphere or the air feels very heavy and thick around you, or you just feel like this sadness in the air. Like I've been to funerals and that feels like that, which is expected because it is a funeral. And so some people are, you know, sad. And even though sometimes it could be a joyous occasion, but they're sad of their lost loved one. And so this is what I want to bring to you today, is it is up to us. And do you believe that it's up to you to set the atmosphere that you want to surround yourself with? It is up to you to set it, to create that atmosphere. Parents, it's up to us to create that atmosphere for our children, to set that tone every day. And so even when we want them to not be running all over the house and we don't want the high energy and the negative energy, it's up to us to create that atmosphere. There are things that we actually have to do to make that happen. Do you know that? Do you believe that there are ways and things that we have to do, that we have to implement in our home and wherever we are, to set that tone and that atmosphere? Do you want to know the ways, or do you already know the ways? Comment below if there are things that you do already that creates a certain type of atmosphere. I would love to hear. Let's share what we do to create that type of atmosphere. What atmosphere do you want? I would love to hear that as well. And comment below, leave a comment so others can see. What do you do to create that atmosphere? I would love to hear as well. And there are things you do. Some of us, we play music. We play music around our house, whether it's positive, uplifting music. We do that to create the positive atmosphere. And there are times too that we also can, just so as an advice to you, start in the morning. So what you do in the morning will also transpire to how you leave your atmosphere and how you set it, how you create it. And so therefore, what you do in the morning helps to set that atmosphere. For me, what I do is I spend my time with God in the morning. I wake up and I spend that time in prayer and praise and worship and thanksgiving. And so I set an atmosphere of thanksgiving in my home. I set an atmosphere, and that way it's positive. And that way we wake up, all of us, thinking about him and being thankful for being alive and being thankful for being able to see another day. So I create that atmosphere by getting up early before everyone else and spending that time. And I walk around my house. There's times I pray in one place And in my prayer room or what, and then there are times I walk around my house and I create that atmosphere and I just send that energy that I want to happen and I want in my space. I send that energy from inside of me outward. And so this is what I'm saying to us as parents. It is up to us to create that. So whatever you desire today, the atmosphere that you want, if you don't want a hostile atmosphere, if you don't want an atmosphere of conflict and confusion, you can't just say it. You can't just say that you want this atmosphere and we're not putting forth the energy or we're not taking the steps towards creating that atmosphere. You don't want a hostile atmosphere. You don't want an atmosphere of drama and you don't want an atmosphere of confusion and conflict. Then therefore, there are things that you have to do. They're the positive. You have to start thinking positive. You have to start embracing positive energy, even if it's through meditation, listening to words of affirmation, positive words to get you thinking positive. That will start your way into creating a positive atmosphere. You have to believe that too, though. It comes also by believing it. And so therefore, if you want that, you have to take some steps to create that atmosphere. And so this is your year to do that. Stop saying that you're tired of, you know, being around conflict and you're tired of the drama. Create an atmosphere that don't allow that energy in your space. Create an atmosphere that is and a standard, even with your family, a standard that is set to say, you know what? You don't come in this space with that. Don't come in this space with that negativity. Don't come in the space with the arguing. Don't come in the space with the drama and the cussing and carrying on. That's not the space. That's not for the space. And when you set that standard, people will respect you. They will respect your atmosphere. They will respect your home because they know that you don't operate that way. And so your atmosphere don't even feel like that. And so in a way too, when they come, and even when they come with that negativity, it will transform them because of the atmosphere that you have created in your home, right? So even when they come with all their chaos and drama, the minute that they step, and you have to believe it, parents and significant others, moms and dads, grandmas, grandpas, whoever is hearing right now, even young people, you have to believe that the atmosphere that you set is set in such a way that even people that come that don't know that type of atmosphere and they don't practice that type of atmosphere, they will be transformed by the atmosphere that you set. You have to believe that. And so today, my question for you and my challenge for you today, does also your conduct and your conversation, does it represent the atmosphere that you set? Because believe it or not, even when you leave out of your atmosphere, when you leave out of your space, when you leave out of your home, you carry that with you. And so does your conduct, does your conversation represent the type of atmosphere you want? The peace that you talk about, the peaceful atmosphere that you want, does your conduct and does your conversation represent that? And so therefore, that is the challenge for us today. You want to create the atmosphere. It's up to you to create the atmosphere. You want a peaceful atmosphere. It's up to you. You want a positive atmosphere. It is up to you. It's up to us all. You want an atmosphere of love and prosperity. It's up to us to create it. Won't you start today to create that atmosphere for you, for your family, for your children, and for others that come into your home and into your space? And the first thing that we can start doing is start within ourselves today. And let our conduct Let our conversation represent the atmosphere that we are creating. And so therefore, when people see us, they will also be transformed by our conversation, by our conduct. And then when they come into our space, they will not feel anything different than what they've experienced by being around you. Right? Amen? So let us do that today. Start with you and start creating that atmosphere within you, within yourself, so it can transpire outward to others, and then create the atmosphere around you. May this encourage you today and challenge you for those things that you desire, that peace, that love, that joy, that hope, those things that you desire within. Start with yourself and let it transcend outward and create the atmosphere from there. Thank you. And also don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Don't forget to like this video. Don't forget to share it with those that you know that is desiring a change and a transformation this year, that they can start with creating that atmosphere within themselves first, so it can transcend outward. Be blessed.